way that we want to think about it is, right now your weight is 50-50. Right? Now when we take the club back with our arm, shoulder, so we want the shoulders to start to swing, the club swings, it swings the arm, get your left shoulder to go down. Now once you get to about here, this is when you're going to start to feel a little weight shift. But what we're seeing right away is you are moving to your right leg. So really the last thing that we want to feel is your weight going over to your right side. So when we look at this, we're not going to see how immediately. See how the weight looks like it stays centered? And then it moves over to the right side. If we look at the report, we see immediately how you're rocking over to the right. Because what do we talk about? We talk about everything moving to the right, going back. We talk about we don't want to crash through that line, right? That's just you swaying a bit to the right. Because once you're there, you're already starting your downswing. And that's when we see that little drift to the left. So we're going to go. This is one. This is two. Hips are three. So we're going to move one, two, then three. And then we reverse it on the way down to where it goes. Three, there's the lower body going first. Shoulder starts to unwind as the club comes down. And that's what's going to ensure that we're back behind it. So all the pieces to the puzzle we have, but we want yours.
Feel yourself move to the right and hit it.
Because we're starting to see that launch start to go away that we had.
Yeah. And that's why, because your head was getting that's your sweet spot right there,
yeah, right?
Yeah. Oh,
that's pretty good right there. That's just a mess. What are you talking about? That's real good there with your head back behind it. So if we just compare that to.
Behind, left shoulder stacking, distance out of your right knee, good head space behind. But court's not done yet. No, we need to change the order in which you wind up. We don't want to slow things down, we don't want to do anything else, but change the order in which you wind up. So when we do that, because when we don't do it, look how you don't drift to the left. Look how you stay behind. That's all the order in which you wind up. If you were an accountant, I would say we're going to do a little LIFO. Last in, first out. So we want the last thing to happen is for you to feel your weight low to your right leg. And the first thing is that we unwind. So here's it in a nutshell for you. Golf is like this. Right? You're playing good, you're getting better, you can beat the world. And then it starts to go down. And then it's, oh boy, I better change something. And you're playing better, you're playing good, you can beat the world. Right. And you can see this on the LPGA, the PGA Tour, you can see people leading up, getting ready to win. You know, you can just see them weeks and weeks, they're playing better. Then you see guys that are on the slide, and girls that are on the slide. Because golf, you never own it. You only borrow it. So what happens is right now we're working on changing the way we wind up. So we can start our trek up. And then eventually we're going to do what we're trying to do. And then we have to go the other way where we're starting to turn more on top. But the thing is, golf is not like this. Doesn't happen that rapidly. Otherwise, it would be terrible because you would shoot even par one day in 90 minutes. You're always working either more steep or more shallow. More steep or more, that's just the way good players work. So, you know, learn that this slopy long slide. It's, you know, we're always working on something the opposite. Make our ball go higher or make our ball go lower. Make our ball turn to the left or make our ball turn to the right. Eventually we do it. Then we have to go the other way. And that's when it starts back up. You understand what I'm saying? So this wintertime stuff is great for us. Okay? It gets us working on positions. It gets us where we want to go with our swing, all that stuff. Now when it comes time to playing stuff, you can't go out there playing golf, thinking of, I gotta have my shoulder come off my chin. I gotta have my weight balanced halfway back. I gotta feel it load up later so I don't drift and my ball can go high. We do that stuff now, so when you go play golf, you play golf. It's a game. You have to play it. It's like doing homework or studying for a test. When you take the test is fun when you know the answer. So, tournament golf is like taking the test after you did all the homework, all your studies, and now you get to show off everything that you know. You know, you have to kind of embrace that. You can't go out there and try and make my 7-iron go high by controlling where my weight goes. All that stuff, because you won't be able to do that for 4.5 hours. When you're playing around the golf. You just have to, when it comes time to play, you have to see what you got. Then when you go back to the range the next day and say, well, I remember I had some trouble with my fairway wood. I wasn't getting them up in the air. I was hitting them too high. Then you use the ball to start to go back and get you to work on what you need to work on. So the next time you play, you don't think you play golf. You know, live. Ball position, stuff like that. What's the wind doing? How far am I? Is it cold? Is it hot? Is it cold?